Without adequate revenue, there will be no resources to fund the budget. So the state will have to resort to borrowing for recurrent expenditure or owing overhead, which is never ideal. So, what are the trends? You know, what have we seen since we came on board 8 months ago? Well, we looked into the books and saw that Oyo State IGR fluctuates. In 2014, it was around 16.3 billion naira. This dropped to about 15.6 in 2015, later increasing to 18.8 in 2016. For 2017, the IGR figures grew to about 22.4 billion, while in 2018, it grew to 24.67 billion. And this put our IGR per capita in 2018 at below 3,000 per person. And just like the Honorable Commissioner said in his opening address, we can definitely do better. Indeed, as clearly stated in our roadmap for accelerated development in Oyo State, 2019 to 2023, our plans to increase the revenue generated in Oyo State without an increase in taxes stand on four legs. One, a thorough review of the current IGR process and management in the state. Two, expanding the tax base. Number three is to look for new sources of revenue. And number four, being aggressive and innovative in the mode of revenue collection by having the State Board of Internal Revenue Service working in collaboration with seasoned professionals. Oyo State has embarked on a comprehensive review of the IGR process and management. We have been able to plug some holes in the system, and this is yielding results. We have also employed new managers of the revenue collection process. Their mandate is to come up with innovative and aggressive ways of getting the untaxed to contribute to the development of the state. The commencement of the new strategies put in place to increase IGR produced the positive result recorded in December 2019, as we raised the IGR to 2.4 billion naira from about 2 billion naira in November. That's an increase of about 400 million naira. And we didn't raise taxes on anybody. Also, we're putting in place a land administration solution that will ensure wider and more effective enumeration of all business and household properties. Ensure ease of obtaining land titles and other documents and faster approval of building plans. So the land use charge has been fine-tuned and will be responsibly applied. Furthermore, we have taken a second look at our vehicle registration and renewal system. And by the end of this month, the public can expect a wider, better, and safer platform which will be available in all our 34 HAT stations. We will continually apply fair and harmonized billings to other rates and levies. It is generally agreed in economic circles that the citizens are more inclined to respond positively and even volunteer to pay their taxes. Bi Iyaloja se so, she appealed to our constituency. Onisewo, onisewo. So the appeal is that people should pay their taxes. So that's positive. The only reason that you can have that positive response is when they see where that tax money is going into. Well, I'm happy to report that the taxes paid by the good people of Oyo State are currently being plowed back into the development of the state. You may be aware of the work being done by the Oyo State Road Maintenance Agency. We are rehabilitating roads not only in Ibadan, but we are moving Hostroma into our zones as well. They're establishing offices in there such that Edubawa ni Isheyi won't need to wait for Ostroma from Ibadan to mobilize to fix their roads out there. So before the end of this quarter, you see Ostroma at work in all of our geopolitical zones. The work being done in the education sector is also taxpayers' money in action. Schools are being rebuilt and renovated. We're concentrating on our final year secondary school students. We want them to return better results in their WAEC exams this year. We're also able to increase the education budget by 700% compared to last year's budget. Because we believe that health is wealth, we're taking steps to ensure that the people of Oyo State remain healthy. Soon, we will roll out a health intervention program across all local government areas in the state. The renovation and equipping of hospitals and primary healthcare centers in the state remain on course. I believe maybe 2 or 3 weeks ago, I approved a pilot program, which is for free intervention across all the local government areas for people that are not able to pay for their medication. It's not my money, it is Oyo State money. In a few months, we are looking to start running a mass transit system in the state. The modalities have been set up and we will communicate the process to you. Of course, what this means is that we will have to find a way of increasing our IGR, especially by looking inwards and exploring areas of competitive advantage. We have to, as a matter of urgency, attract investment into Oyo State. Of course, you've seen the security outfit, SRS, you've seen the vehicles, you've seen the communication system. We did all of that to give confidence to investors to be able to come into Oyo State. So attracting direct investment will take a collective effort. This administration will continue to invest in security and take other measures to ensure that we create an enabling environment for the growth of investment in Oyo State. On your part, you should be ready to extend the traditional hospitality to strangers, making them feel welcome in our midst. I visited an elder in the States recently. We're just the two of us in the room. And the Baba called me and said, "Sheyi, Sumabi." So I was wondering, because I don't listen to her, we're just two. Alice are really. But I got up and I knelt beside him. And he said, "She, you truly suffer me, just me and you. If we let you know what I think, she will go to the." Well, it is your state money. It is your tax money. And we will continue to use those money for the overall benefit of the people of Oyo State.